हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू आवर होम लर्निंग सेशन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन रिपोर्टेड स्पीच दैट इज इन टू पार्ट, डायरेक्ट स्पीच, इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. नाउ व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट स्पीच? द एक्चुअल वर्ड्स ऑफ स्पीकर आर कोटेड एज इट इज विदाउट एनी चेंज. Means the exact words of the speaker are enclosed in inverted commas. This mark we are using as a inverted commas. Means whatever speaker spoke the sentence, that same to same exact words are used in inverted commas, that is direct speech. Now what is indirect speech? The actual words of the speaker are transformed. Means whatever direct speech, same to same words are there, that will be transformed by following some rules. The words of speaker are not enclosed in inverted commas as they are transformed. Means in indirect speech, inverted commas will be not there. Now let us see example. Yogesh said to John, I am studying. This one is direct speech. Now direct speech having four parts, 1, 2, 3, and 4th. First part is known as speaker. Second part is known as reporting verb. Third part is known as listener. And fourth part is known as reported speech. Speaker will speak the sentence and listener will listen the sentence. And said to, that is reporting verb. According to reporting verb, if said is there, said or said to, then reported speech tenses will be changed. And pronoun of the reported speech, it will change according to speaker or listener. Now let us go forward. Few things you should know for changing into direct speech, indirect speech. What are that? For that, three concepts should be clear. First one, subject and object. That is, subject means speaker. Here Yogesh is speaker, so subject, and listener, that is object. So John is listener, so object. Next concept is for first person, second person, third person. Now I will give you example. First person means here Yogesh and John. Yogesh is speaker and John is listener. So first person means if I will speak out, that is first person. If you are listening, that are second person. And if we are talking about another person, that is third person. Now next is tense. How many tenses are there? Present, past and future. That will be transformed as a simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense, present continuous tense, past continuous tense, future continuous tense. That way, perfect, perfect continuous, total 12 tenses we are having. So that tenses, am writing, that is a present continuous tense, convert into was writing, that is past continuous tense. So that way, tenses also you have to remember. Now I will give you idea about a first person, second person, third person. First person, which pronouns are there in that first person? They are I, we, me, us, my, mine, our, us, myself, ourselves. These are the first person pronoun. Second person pronoun, you, your, yours, yourself, yourselves. Now look at it, yourself, that is singular, and yourselves is plural. You we are using as a singular also and plural also. Third person pronoun, he, his, him, she, her, hers, it, its, they, them, their, theirs, himself, herself, themselves. And one more, itself. Right? So these all are third person pronoun. Thank you.